the sea berry. So this is a normal sea berry tree, or shrub, or shrubby tree as I like to call it. They get, yeah, about this size, a couple of meters. Well, except for this crazy big one I found at the city garden. I had no idea it could get this big. Get yourself a handful of these berries, because eating them can give you the endurance of Spartans, the longevity of an oak tree the size of 6 meters wide, and bring the youth of your ancestors back to your bones. Order some seeds online if you don't have fresh available. This is how simple the seeds look, even though they pack enormous power. Spray that paper towel moist, fold it nice and tidy, like you would with your stunning outfit. Put it in a jar, put the lid on, and then put it in the fridge for a few weeks or months. Alternatively, you can take some seeds and put it in some moist dirt, and then put this dirt outside for winter. And after about 25 days, I took them out, and this is how you see they germinated. Super small, tiny white roots poking out of the shells. So put a couple of seeds in the dirt and cover them just slightly. And the reason I take 3 seeds instead of just one is simply because hard chance of survival. But more on that later. Give the dirt a proper moist so the seeds can grow. After 1 week, only 2 have sprouted so far. 6 weeks has passed and the last one finally did come up.
But it's locked up!
Needs to break out!
69 days.
Now you can see clearly why I said 3 seeds is a really good idea. One is tiny and one is crooked, maybe sick. And the middle one looks best by far. Extraordinary.
Ferment! It's starting to really get some properties, right? The middle one made some knots, or some nodules, or whatever you want to call them. It certainly does start to look like a grown-up plant in a tiny size. And the sick one is starting to grow in a circle. A little while later, and they started to grow some shooters and outward growth. And this plant does tend to be like this, because it can be invasive.
May become a huge tree, load of the berries, tasty looking.
Here's some useful info, pause the video and read for yourself. This is a mature male tree, and it got these flowers looking like small pine cones. And this female plant is starting to grow some berries. I do wonder what will happen if you grafted them together. It's said that the berries is sour as lemon, times 2, and that's because they were forged in the smiths of gods, and only those deemed worthy champions could eat them raw. Half a year has passed, and a small tiny one has gotten itself a cool little branch. And the one that I thought was sick is now my favorite. It just spins around in a circle and it's a tangled mess with shoots and branches and everything. I'm so glad I didn't cut it off. And then there's the middle one who's trying to become the Pisa Tower.
Oh, you're not convinced yet? The Hippophae Rhamnoides, horse shine. Back in the days, when they fed horses these berries, they would become so healthy they started shining. They tolerate cold Eskimo weather, super dry, sandy and salty soil, even make their own nitrogen to feed themselves. May these berries bless you and your next generations. Subscribe for more.